going, everyone? It is Liam Catterson here, and we're reacting to another episode of She-Hulk, as we're on episode number 7, 3 episodes left to go, which is sad for me, because I have really enjoyed watching this show. It's been really, really incredible. Tatiana has killed it as Jen, which for me was to be expected, because after watching Orphan Black, I got an idea of how incredibly talented she was, and I had no doubts whatsoever about the fact that she would ace it in She-Hulk, and for me, she definitely has done that. So yeah, I am excited to see where these 3 episodes will go. Obviously, we are expecting certain appearances, which I don't expect. A certain devil will show up in this episode as well, because I did make the mention last week, but I feel like they are saving him for the final 2 episodes, if anything. I don't know if he's going to appear in episode 8 or 9, but they are definitely saving him for something bigger, and obviously we still have that situation with Jen's blood trying to be acquired. We saw that tease in the end of the last episode. So, you know, not ominous whatsoever, but yeah, I only bring this up because I know a lot of people were disappointed with last week's episode, given the fact that episode 5 obviously teased the return of Daredevil, and you know, it's just a teaser at the end of the day. There was no promise to say that he was going to appear in episode 6 or he's going to appear in this episode, etc., just that he is coming. And, you know, as a certain captain once said, patience. So this isn't, you know, I think people are sometimes forgetting that this is a show about She-Hulk and not Daredevil. So yeah, like, there are people who do watch this only for Daredevil, and it's like, there is a site called YouTube, and I'm sure someone is going to upload all of the Daredevil scenes up there once, you know, he does appear, kind of like what they've done with Kenobi with certain appearances, etc. So yeah, but you know, that's my 2 cents, because, you know, the amount of people that's been complaining about something that, you know, wasn't really a guarantee has just been a bit ridiculous, in my opinion. So yeah, but hey-ho, I'm enjoying this journey. So with that said, let's continue this journey. This is episode number 7 of She-Hulk. Let's go. You know what? My Orphan Black mind was expecting her to be like, you're damn right. I don't trust Josh. Not so whatsoever. I don't trust him. I don't trust him. Fries dipped in milkshake. See, further reason not to trust him. That sounds horrible. Wait, is he gone or? Yeah. He just ditched her.
Oh, are you going down a rabbit hole on that intelligentsia site?
What? No, I don't care what a bunch of losers say about me online. They say it to my face because they know they get Hulk smashed.
Nerdrotic is crying in the corner right now as we speak.
That's enough for you.
Josh, what the hell? Oh, this is Uber Eats, isn't it? Yeah, 20% off your offer.
Got that right.
We got a malfunction alert on Blonsky's inhibitor.
Did he turn into the abomination?
We don't know, so.
I gotta go up to that wackadoo ranch of his.
Okay, well, I'll check in with
him. As long as he's, you know, being
right
good.
You on over to why I called.
I know he hasn't checked it, but there, like, you could see it pop up on your phone and then just be like, swipe away. And just absolutely ghost her. Dick.
Jostled it, or?
Come to think of it, I did get a jolt from an electric fence earlier, but it was worth it because my favorite chicken Princess Silkfeather was stuck.
Your favorite chicken.
Yeah.
Oh, he was looking out. He was looking out for his chickens.
I have recalibrated your inhibitor, and she is
good move, Habil.
So, stay away from the electric.
Well, I've already wasted half a Sunday on this expedition, so I'm gonna get moving.
Jen. Oh! Whoa! What the shit? Time out!
Give us a push to the garage, would you?
Do I look like a mechanic? Oh. My name's Man Bull, not Mechanical Bull.
Wow. Hey!
How long have you been waiting to say that?
Yeah.
Very forced.
You too?
The tow truck won't get here until late. This is Porcupine. He's a porcupine. And Saracen thinks he's a vampire.
Wow, this is quite a group.
Maybe he is a vampire.
To join.
Foreshadowing for blind.
I'm just going to work over here in the one square meter. Okay.
Last session.
Yes.
Yeah. How taking your suit off would be
beneficial.
Great first step.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe he's one with the suit.
I
just feel safer with it on. Thank you.
Okay.
That guy's here? You probably don't even remember who he is. Tell me they previously on him. No, I don't care. We're doing it again. Previously on this guy.
The fourth wall. I was going to say he's one of the wrecking crew, isn't he? Oh, my goodness.
I was visited by a lot of feminine energy in there. I think I was talking to my dead grandmother.
As soon as I'm out of there, I'm going to rip this guy to shreds.
Okay, hold on. That is not how we work through our issues around.
I mean, he was a dick.
Okay.
But she's got to get her own chair.
Okay.
I'd love to work through our issues.
For God's sake.
If you'll let me.
Got to get some explaining done.
Real strength comes from facing yourself in the mirror and saying, hey, man, I'm going to work on me.
When's the last time you talked to him?
3 nights ago. When we
made love.
First off, ew.
Very, no, very, very
for the first time.
Blunt.
Direct heat.
Okay, are you two married?
Come on.
Mm-hmm. Codependency. Actually, could you switch seats with someone?
Oh my God.
Okay, that's not exactly the last thing I texted him.
I'm sorry, what?
Well, just now, because I was so worried. I hadn't heard from him in so long. For
she's
all I knew, he was
she's
in a
wanting
ditch
this
somewhere.
To work.
What did you do?
Hey. Getting a little worried. Just want to know you're okay. Oh. Blushing stains.
Oh. Start considering the very real possibility that you were ghosted.
Or he wanted your blood.
No, not that.
Man, stop talking about blood. Not everybody's your dad.
I mean, he might have a point.
You know in high school, that friend that you have that's like, like, cooler than you are? Like, more attractive and athletic. And they get all the attention from everyone.
She's dealing with that with herself.
Hello.
Like, it's sad.
So, like, I meet this guy who actually likes Jen, and that just felt good to know that.
Breakthrough.
You know? And then he ghosts me, and it sucks.
See, this is why Josh needs to be yeeted to the sun.
All right, screw this guy. Where does he live?
Let's go. Oh, let's yes! I'm with the porcupine!
When someone rejects us, because it reminds us of the times we reject ourselves.
Maybe this Josh thing hurts so much because you haven't been spending enough time with Jen.
And that's a shame.
There's a group of guys right here who would love to spend time with Jen right now.
I'm not in
Jen,
the group.
Do you believe that this
but
group
I would.
Genuinely values the whole of you?
I do.
Yeah!
Bravo.
Great job.
I gotta say, that felt really good.
Yeah.
Felt really good, Porcupine.
Come on, buddy, come on.
Oh my God.
It smells like a fart.
Too much.
Oh, goodness.
Those are good. Oh, man.
It's a step.
How many hours a day have you been wearing that mask, Papa?
What, am I ashy?
No.
Did you?
Delete it. Yeah! Okay. Fuck Josh!
How do you feel?
Can't believe I'm gonna say this, but...
Better?
I'm hurt. Bye, Jen. We love Jen and She-Hulk.
We do.
The gang. That's nice.
When it says gang, it's not literal gang. I mean, just make sure you make that clear to
friends.
The floorboard.
Friends. Yeah. Fam. Yeah. I don't know. What a dick. Hulk King. Had a fucking feeling. Josh is an absolute asshole. I mean, I even did express my worries in the last episode. That was that light bulb moment that went off. That what if Josh is using Jen? What a fucking surprise! Yeah, he was being too comfy with Jen in terms of, oh, nothing bad could happen. Like, you were just waiting for that moment where Jen would just get hurt, and yeah. I mean, I did really love how everyone in that group was very supportive of Jen. And they were trying to reach the best of both worlds, really. Whereas Jen has always been in that position where She-Hulk needs to emerge, because that's where people will embrace her. So, and that's sad. It's sad, isn't it? Because, you know, Jen is a very, very amazing character herself. And yeah, it's not just that, though, but there's also the deal with Josh as well. Like, you want this to thrive. And then you just get ghosted, etc. And yeah, so fuck Josh. Fuck him. What an absolute prick. Yeah, this YouTube channel is an anti-Josh channel. Fuck him. He is, you know, the type of person who can get hit by a truck. I don't care. I don't make the rules. I mean, the group were willing to absolutely ambush him, and I would have been okay with that, to be fair. What an absolute manipulative dickhead. Yeah, he is, you know, he is the type of guy who just makes my stomach churn and, you know, deserves to get kneed in the balls a thousand times is enough. Yeah, I don't know. But, yeah, I am wondering if that's, with that ending in mind, we're definitely going to see that final confrontation. He becomes Hulk King, and, I need to sit a bit further back if I can get my words out. We're going to see that final confrontation. We're going to have, Jen and Matt take on Hulk King, potentially. I'm not sure. Like you said, it could be if the fact that Matt could emerge in the next episode. And I definitely do feel like that might be the case, potentially. Especially with the fact that we might have Jen and Daredevil... not Jen and Daredevil. Jen and Hulk King have a one-on-one battle. I can definitely see Matt try to give a bit more of that confidence that Jen was suffering from. Wow. I mean, that was really, really great. I mean, I know people might not take too much from this episode because it was featuring this group that was giving a bit of a pep talk to Jen, trying to boost that confidence. But I think this really does add layers, especially with the fact that there has been this struggle with the fact that Jen has been pushed to the sidelines, and the moment she feels like she can finally be accepted, her confidence just gets brought down to rock bottom, you could say, because there is this moment where someone accepts you for who, like, they don't see the She-Hulk, they see Jen, and they embrace her so much, and then 2 seconds later, he ghosts you. That is going to be an absolute, that's going to be absolutely detrimental to the greatest point, really, for Jen. Because there is nothing more crushing than someone who can embrace certain sides to you and then just ditch you completely and then just brings your confidence to an all-time low. I know that from experience, especially with hoping that people can, accept my autism, really. And 'cause there is that idea that people just, think of us as weird, someone to stay away from, that there is this lack of acceptance. And when you find someone who does that, it can be very, very enlightening. And, you know, I've been in Jen's position before where, you know, I've met someone who can embrace certain sides to me. And, you know, that can raise my spirits and then get ghosted. So, and it can be absolutely crushing. So I can understand why Jen was absolutely distraught with the fact that there is this Jen side that no one wants to, they see the She-Hulk, and you find someone who meets that side of you that no one else really want that really cares for, and then yeah, you just get ghosted. So it just really is sad, though. Like there was that moment, and again Tatiana killed it, where she made that speech about, like, would people like me if I didn't have the She-Hulk? And, you know, it is really, really crushing, isn't it? In the essence that you've got this side to you. And, you know, it's not even the side you were born with. You weren't even this a year ago. And now suddenly people are talking about you and... You know, it can be very, very damaging for your self-confidence. So, yeah, Jen opening up to the group, it really did break my heart, because this has been a culmination of all of the struggles that she's faced this season. So it wasn't a pointless thing whatsoever. And you've really got to embrace the entire story to find that heartbreaking moment, because we have seen people have that stance where, you know, they would be rather Team She-Hulk than Team Jen, which is really, really sad. Like, you want to embrace, like, you should really, really embrace everything about a person if you have that, you know, want to liking them. Pending it's good, of course. And that is, of course, the situation with Jen. Both Jen and She-Hulk are both great attributes. You know, it's something that you can embrace, really. It's nothing... like, one isn't bad whatsoever. And yet people are, you know, just put off by one side of things. And then are just on the completely opposite end of things with She-Hulk mainly. So... It's just that there was that moment where she thought that Josh would like her for both, it would be the best of both worlds, really. And at the end of the day, it is very damaging when he just ghosts you. So, yeah, and it can have a real, real knock on confidence. So, especially with that buildup of all the times that people have said, I would date She-Hulk, but not Jen. So, yeah. And it's just really, really... You know, I just want to give, Jen a hug, really. So, I mean, I would with She-Hulk. Like I said, it's something... it's where you embrace the best of both worlds, but... Jen definitely needs that support more, because, as she said, would people, like, she made the point about, would people embrace me if I didn't have this, if I didn't Hulk out, etc. So, yeah. And I am really, really glad that she had that group, which also featured Emil, to have her back, really. So, not just in terms of wanting to break Josh's legs. Get in line, people. No, but they really accepted her. And it is really, really nice to see that support, how they were trying to how they were lending their ears to Jen and her troubles. And it is, like I said, it's really, really sad that Jen had to express that, because you know, Jen is amazing, She-Hulk is amazing, and yeah, Josh is an absolute dickhead. The fact that he used her like that, manipulated her emotions, gave her that hope, really, that, okay, I finally found someone that can accept Jen as well as She-Hulk. You know, they're not partial to one side of things. And then he does that. He not just ghosts her, but obviously the elephant in the room, which is stealing the blood, which, yeah, so... I mean... It is sad to say that I had my suspicions in the last episode that Josh was up to no good. And obviously it comes to fruition, because you just want to, like, especially in this situation where Jenna has had that struggle about the fact that people would embrace She-Hulk but not Jen. You just want to hope that you're wrong, because you don't want Jen to feel like shit, and... here we are. So, I feel so bad for Jen, and, yeah, so, but I am really, really glad that she had those, like, she had that group, all these, people, who were supportive of her, and want, who had her back, really, so... It was really, really, I mean, there was a fun dynamic involved, but I really loved the deepness that there were at certain times as well. So, but it was just really, really devastating hearing Jen's situation and how that moment where she finally thinks that someone can embrace Jen as well as She-Hulk, that, you know, they would want to listen to Jen, that they treat Jen like a queen. It just all comes crashing down because of the fact that, yeah, Josh is the type of person who doesn't deserve love. I've said it. Like, those people who just manipulate you, ghost you, etc. Fuck you. So, yeah. So, hopefully Josh gets... humbled so badly in the last episode, because I think that's where we're heading in terms of him acquiring blood, him being Hulk King. Yeah, so final confrontation, all that jazz. But no, I really loved it. Like I said, there was a fun dynamic, obviously, but it was really, really sad hearing Jen's struggles. So that's the important thing. It wasn't more so the struggles with She-Hulk, it was the struggles with Jen, really. Because when you think about the last episode where she finally got to embrace just being Jen and being accepted for that, where she tries to shun the idea of wanting to become She-Hulk because of the fact that people are more so interested about She-Hulk and not Jen. It, you know, all these... elements in the prior episode, it all comes around here in a very, very moving piece where she expresses her struggles, and obviously Josh was the final straw, really, because of the fact that Jen was accepted, and ultimately it just ended up in tragedy, really, because of the fact that in the end Jen was just being used, really, for Josh's goals. So obviously she doesn't know that a bit of her blood has been taken yet, but still, in terms of a real world sense, it still stings, doesn't it, because of the fact that being ghosted, like I said, I've been there, it does suck, especially for someone who will accept all of you, so you think, just to be left hanging is just, yeah, gonna absolutely send you crashing down. So fuck you, Josh. You're gonna get what you deserved in the final episode, so yeah. Like I said, this is an anti-Josh channel now, so yeah. But no, this was really, really great stuff. I enjoyed that episode. Very, very, I don't know what I was kind of expecting with this episode. Like I said, I wasn't expecting a certain devil to show up, so yeah. But I think the, like I said, it works well because of past elements about the whole She-Hulk, Jen Walters situation and how that creates a very, very detrimental effect for Jen. It works really, really well. And all of that, everything that has come about in terms of people's preference for She-Hulk rather than Jen, it I think it pays off really, really well in a moving emotional way where you just want to hug Jen to death. So not literally, of course, but yeah, I want to give the biggest hug to Jen right now. So yeah. But yeah, I will see you guys next time. Hope you guys enjoyed this reaction. Check my videos on the right if you want to check out more of my content. You can also subscribe to my media feeds and channel if you want to. Hope you guys enjoyed this reaction. Hope you guys take care, and I will see you guys next time. Toodles!